I know this is going to sound hokey to say what I wanted to be when I grew up, but I actually wanted to be a sports writer. I grew up in Vancouver, British Columbia, where we had a football team, the BC Lions, and I used to keep a scrapbook from the newspaper that I would cut out, and then I would write my own commentary on the pictures, under the pictures and things like that. Colorado was an amazing place to move in the 1990s. We were in the throes of a newspaper war, and I entered the newspaper war as the metro editor of the Rocky Mountain News.
And John Temple put his shoulder to the wheel, and he really put a lot of time into hiring the right reporters, competing to get reporters. I mean, it was a newspaper war, and he was ready for battle.
And for a while, Denver really had, probably for a city of this size, the best newspaper journalism in the country, in my view. And he was instrumental in having that realized.
When I was running for mayor, we went there for the try to get the endorsement. You got to remember, I was nobody. Like almost 6 weeks before the election, way earlier than you would normally do an endorsement, they did an endorsement that, I mean, it staggered me.
I mean, we won 4 Pulitzer Prizes, but that really wasn't the measure. The measure was, did we do work worthy of that kind of recognition? And clearly every year we were. Final Salute was probably one of the high points of the newspaper. This was the Pulitzer Prize winning section that won for both photography and for feature writing. There was nothing we didn't believe we could do, and we all believed we could do things better together than separately.
Somebody said, you never know what you can do until John Temple says, get it done. And then you're like, okay, I've got to get this impossible story done.
One of the things, that lessons we learned was that really came during Columbine, the 1999 school shooting, which was a turning point for the paper, when we decided that we would share everything with the world in real time. And it was a really important decision because it was our real entry at that point into the digital world and the internet world, because when you do that, your material travels all over the globe very, very quickly. People used to say about the Rocky, my Rocky. It's very unusual to hear people describe a news organization or a newspaper or a website or a TV station as their own. And that meant that they had an affection and a closeness to it that really stood out. When we knew the Rocky was going to close, or when we knew that was potentially imminent, it was a really difficult time. That even though the news devastated them personally, it was really difficult to hear. They immediately grabbed notebooks and cameras and started reporting. And I'm sure that all of us who were there that day feel proud of the final edition we put out after hearing, you know, terrible professional news.
The Rocky was just this family, and it was so hard because it was really the death of a family.
I think that's a key lesson about anything like the Hall of Fame. It's not about an individual, it's about the group of us working together. And I was very lucky to work with some people who I wish could be with us and are no longer with us.